Hey everyone, Laser Dave here again with Trotech Laser, and I have a brand new video series. I always get the same question, can you laser it? So this web series is going to seek out the most far-reaching items and materials to answer that question. And I will put these items into the laser and see how they perform. Today, I have something that needs an answer. Beef jerky. Can it be laser engraved and cut? Come with me, let's find out. Step one, purchase an obscene amount of jerky for testing. I have done that, and we're gonna now put that into the laser system and find out how it performs. I have created a file about the size of the beef jerky. What I have done is taken the Trotech logo and converted it to 10 different colors that match the Trotech color palette. We're then going to push print to the laser system for the engraving process and see how this performs. I have also created already a setting for beef jerky. What I have done is assigned a different power setting for each of the 10 colors I assigned the Trotech logo. Each one of these power settings are 10% different in power at the same speed so that we can see what power setting performs best on the beef jerky. We will start at 10% power, up to 20, 30, 40, all the way up to 100% power with a 10% increase per material. So I'm gonna go ahead and send that to the laser. I'm gonna run at a low DPI as well. I don't think this material, based on experience, will require a high resolution. So let's run at 333, just shooting in the dark here. We also want to make sure that the process mode color is turned on to work with all these different colors. Send this file to job control. Select the file off of the list. And we're now ready to send this file to the laser. So now let's place the beef jerky into the laser system. We're gonna move the laser over the surface of the beef jerky. Then let's go ahead and hit the focus button over here. And focus onto the surface of the beef jerky. Never thought I'd be saying that. Okay, it is showtime. Let's find out exactly how this material performs on the laser system. Starting the laser, I went ahead and used Air Assist. And so this is going to be 10% laser power. First setting is going to be 10%. We'll see how 10% performs onto beef jerky. Looks like we're not getting any type of discernible response. Yeah, looks like a little bit, but not too much. So let's find out how 20% works. Looks like 20% is looking way better. Look at that. It's almost bright white. Interesting. Actually, that was 30%. I couldn't see 20%. Okay, we're now at 40% laser power. Looks like 40%. And this is a 120-watt laser. So we're running at 100% speed, and we're running now at 50% laser power. Looks like 50% laser power is a little overpowered, but that's why we run these tests, to find out exactly how this material is going to perform. Okay, we're coming up on 60%. 60% laser power. Way a lot of power, starting to produce some interesting little patterning and fibers forming into the surface of the raw, or the into the surface of the meat. Okay, we're now at 80% laser power. Looks like quite a bit overpowered at this point, producing a strange residue all around the engraving. 90%, considerably more laser power. Wow, interesting. Now 100% laser power onto the surface of beef jerky. Let's see exactly what this looks like. Here's a closer shot. As you can see, it looks like right around 10% didn't perform at all. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. We're starting to get lots of interesting residue on there. 70, I've got all kinds of dust and debris. 80, a little bit more. 90 and up to 100 is definitely too much power. So it looks like my best power setting is approximately 40 to 50% power. Not too much residue. It's nice and clean. Great contrast, something I would not have expected on this material. So we're going to kind of stick with right between 40 and 50% laser power, it looks like. Okay, let's now see if this laser system is going to cut. So now this time I have created just some circles and some squares and in several different colors as well. And so what I'm going to do in this case, print those to the laser, just like we did before for the color settings. But in this case, I have one set for cut. And if I go into my cut settings, we can see here I have assigned a power setting of 100% power for all six different colors I'm going to test. And then I've assigned a speed setting ranging from 0.8% speed, 1, 1.2, 1.4, 1.8, and 2% speed. And so the laser is going to start out doing a quick test cut at 2, and then it's going to slow down further and further until we're able to achieve all six colors. I didn't do as many colors for the cutting because I kind of have a hunch of where this setting might be. But in the meantime, let's go ahead and send this to the laser. Print, open up job control, and let's bring this file directly out and we'll snap it to the cursor. And let's go over to the laser now and see exactly what setting is going to best cut this material. Okay, we are still focused onto the surface of the material from the engraving process. So let's go ahead and now push the start button again and see which one of these settings cut it out. So here's the fastest one. Second one, looks like the circle's cutting out. All right. Wow. Interesting amount of residue that's actually on the laser or on the actual surface of the jerky as well. So let's see which setting best cut out. It looks like right about, looks like we're getting some hanging on the part here. So definitely it looks like my settings are about 1.4 is giving me my best looking cut for this material. So we now know what kind of setting, at least for this brand and this thickness, what material setting. And I have to tell you, this smells awful. It's got it's not a pleasant smell whatsoever. Smells like burning flesh. So just FYI, not recommended, I think, just for the smell factor, because woo. Now let's go ahead and engrave some cool graphics I have created and cut those graphics out on the laser system using our newly discovered settings. As you can see, the engraving is looking really good with this intricate detailed graphic. Kind of an inverted state since it turns white when it engraves. However, the contrast is outstanding and totally unexpected from originally thought when I started this project. We're about halfway through. I'm also gonna cut the outline of these out to create a interesting looking finished image. Now that I know the response turns white, I might try this again, inverting the image to a negative so that it looks positive when it's engraved. All right, let's take a closer look at this. There we have it, the finished image with high contrast marks. But as I said before, it looks negative. So let's go ahead and invert the graphics and try this again and see if we can't improve the overall look of this finished product. This time I inverted the graphic so that it is negative on the screen. So hopefully this time it will engrave positive on the beef jerky, producing a more realistic looking finished result. So far the graphic is looking way better. I really like the results when it comes to processing a negative. So what that says is, yes, beef jerky cuts nice, it engraves nice. It also requires the image to be negative. So the black will turn white and the white will turn black to give you a negative contrast. So the contrast on the screen has to be negative in order to engrave positive. However, I am truly amazed on the contrast and detail I'm able to achieve. Now, I do suggest making sure that you buy real flat pieces if you're gonna do this. And this is, of course, for novelty purposes only. I would not suggest doing this more for display purposes or images on a website, maybe specified, you know, logos and stuff like that, but not for anything else unless you have some type of FDA certification for this and the laser is not used for doing anything but this. I would check your local FDA certification rules and laws if you plan on doing this for actual consumption. However, right now I'm doing this purely for novelty purposes as just to determine the question, will it laser? And the answer is an asserting absolute yes. Okay, that is a lot better. Inverting the graphic has produced a realistic looking high contrast mark that was engraved and cut into beef jerky with outstanding results. Okay, final test. If anyone knows me, they know that I like to push the limits. And so if we can do a simple text and then go into a more elaborate graphic, why not a full photograph? So I am going to attempt an engraving and a cutout of an actual photograph onto beef jerky. This has got to be a world's first. So let's go ahead and hit start and find out how this is going to perform. I have inverted this graphic so that it is in a negative form, knowing how the material responds. And then now we're going to go ahead and see about potentially engraving the world's first, well, at least in my opinion, a world's first photograph on beef jerky. It's definitely the world's first cowboy engraved onto the surface of beef jerky. So far it's looking great. I can see the horse's head. Image quality looks good. I've also traced the outline around this, manually tracing around it, knowing that the background is gonna kind of turn white. So after it's finished, I have set the laser to actually cut out the photograph with a slight contour or offset around the outside of the graphic itself. I have to say that beef jerky engraving is amazing me. I would have never expected that beef jerky would engrave with this kind of detail and contrast, or even have the ability of this much detail and contrast. So definitely a worthwhile test to determine, will it laser? The answer is a wow, yes it will. So we've now got a horsey coming in on the person's head and face. Now of course you're gonna have flaws and imperfections into the surface of something like cured meat, so you can't expect perfection. There are small holes all over the graph or the piece of beef jerky. Just part of the character, I think. Now we are just about finished, so let's go ahead and go into the cutting motion here. My calculations were set right. I should be able to cut out just around the outline of the cowboy to produce a laser engraved and cut photograph into the surface of beef jerky. There we have it, our finished results, an outstanding example of an engraved photograph on beef jerky, also cut out with great contrast and detail, answering the question, yes, it can laser. If you have something you would like to see me try, please let me know in the comment section. And if I select your idea, I will send you a $100 credit for Trotec materials. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to see what I laser next. We'll see you next time.